Okay, just a few more tips on Access Form Design. Same form as a previous lesson. Now, if there's a field such as this field here where the user should not type anything, I make the background color something other than white. That way the user knows that they're not supposed to type anything in there. And I also take off the tab stop property that prevents the cursor from landing on that field if the user presses the tab key. So for example, suppose you decide the user should never type in the goals against average, right? So let's go here to properties. Then tab stop character is under the other tab, right? So if you click on that, it turns the tab stop property to no. And if you don't want the user to enter anything in there, you can make the back color something other than white, right? So suppose you make it light blue, right? Also, under the data tab, you can say locked equals yes. That means that user is not allowed to change the value of that field. Now, another thing that you should do is if a field is used for text, you can use any font that you want, right? But if a field is used for numeric, you should use the Courier New font, because the Courier New font is the Microsoft Windows non-proportional font, which means that every digit is the same width, right? So for example, here this is a Courier New font, right? So if I type a 1, if I type a 9, if I type an 8, no matter what digit I type, it's always the same width, right? Whereas here, this is a normal font, if you will, a proportional font, which means that narrow letters like I and L are shown as a narrow, but big letters like W are wide, right? So that's okay for reading, but it's not so okay for numbers, because when you have numbers, you kind of want them to all line up so that they're kind of in a column. So there, and then see, I'll demonstrate the tab stop property also. See, right now I'm on the year field. If I hit the tab, I go to the next field. If I hit the tab, I go to the next field, and so on like that, right? That's controlled by the tab index character, which is here under other, right? There's the tab index. The first field is called tab index 0. The next field is called tab index 1. The next field is called tab index 2. And there's tab index 3, tab index 4, tab index 5. And this field is tab index 6, but if you hit tab, it won't stop on that field because we have set the tab stop property to null. Okay, so those are just a few additional tips on how to do stuff with access forms.